part of the envelope that you intended to give during the gift. We are about, and I have the bulletin in front of me, but I would say we're about $7,000 short from meeting our goal of $20,000. So any large gift would be appreciated, and a bunch of small gifts would add up and take care of that. So I encourage anybody who would still like to make a year-end gift to prayerfully consider and make that gift today. With that, I ask us to please stand so that we can sing our opening hymn.
day you revealed your Son to the nations by leading of a star. Lead us now by faith to know your presence in our lives and bring us at last to the full vision of your glory. Through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. Thanks be to God. Thanks be to God.
Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we have observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all of the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word so that I also may go and pay him homage." When they heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. They were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road. This is the gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Grace to you and peace in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The festival of Epiphany, a day of stars, of candles, trees still lit, we still get to sing Christmas carols, and it's a rather grand day of remembering the story of the wise people coming from countries far to worship the child Jesus. Festival days and feast days are quite fun, especially for preachers and clergy folk and rostered leaders who like to wear fancy stoles, and musicians who so gratefully add an extra prelude with the harpsichord. It's fun to celebrate. And we've had Christmas and Epiphany. Now we're going to go in. Well, next week we have the Baptism of our Lord. That's another feast day. But then we go into all these Sundays after Epiphany that are ordinary Sundays. Today we get to hear the story of the star and lights. But there's really more to it than just the star shining, a backstory, the context of this story. There's more to Christmas than just sweet baby Jesus with peaceful parents glowing in first-time parenthood. Those of you who've been first-time parents know that the pictures of Mary and Joseph gazing so adoringly doesn't last a real long time with the baby. But that's our picture, that's the story, and today the story is more than just those wise people with their camels and their treasure chests. This is about people who had to be registered back where they came from, their home country, not a place to live when visited at some point by those hired hands who likely wouldn't have set foot in town if they hadn't been set by the angels. It's a story fraught with politics and upside-down events. Messiah in a feeding trough, king in a cave, prince of peace born somewhere, unwelcomed, and then welcomed by strangers, shepherds quaking in their sandals. Then there's this gospel, today's gospel, the festival of the star. A star that shines then, shines now, in the midst of political power struggles, a perception that time by a paranoid ruler that a child somewhere, somehow, was going to depose him, who connived with the scholars, astrologers, travelers from distant lands to find that one and to end the threat against him by neutralizing opposition. Wise isn't big enough a word for those people. There's people with camels and, as the legend has it, treasure chests of gifts. Not only were they wise celebrate the Word made flesh that makes our flesh, our lives sacred. We celebrate God becoming us, so that whether we are young, whether we're older, wondering what to do when we grow up, or how to grow old, or how to be sick, or how to die, here is the good news for you and for all people, that God in Jesus is here with us, with you, and with everyone. A couple weeks ago at Prince of Peace, where Rick and I worship, we were saying the words of the Creed, proclaiming and affirming our faith in God made human. When a man walked down the center aisle, slowly, kind of weaving from side to side, looking perhaps like one of the shepherds, a person in Bethlehem on the streets late at night, or one of the people on a side street as the camels walked by. He walked right up to the stairs of the altar while the congregation continued with the creed, while the pastors and the assisting minister and the acolytes did their part. He walked up to the steps and knelt, head on the tile. Knelt while we said, "He became flesh, born of the Virgin Mary, become human, God of God, light of light." And he knelt as the shepherds and the wise men might have knelt when they realized that God was in that place, that nothing else mattered except getting close, trying to push through and to get by, having made so many other choices one way or another, late at night, early in the morning, when addiction or dysfunction or food or politics or anger or grief or fear seemed far more important. But at that moment, nothing in the whole world was more important. And they all fell on their knees. And then the man on the steps at the foot of the manger and the foot of the cross got up and walked out. Back to the street, back to his life, having found, I pray, one moment when he had the experience of the peace that passes all our understanding, where he felt part of the God-child in the manger, lying in holiness, where for that instant we all become shining in the light of Christ. The star shines in the darkness, and there is nothing on earth
God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Gathered with all who seek the Christ child, let us pray for the church, the world, and all who are in need.
Faithful God, continue to provide dedicated leaders and passionate people for your church, so that wisdom and compassion in all its rich variety may be made known throughout the world. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Give your justice to the leaders of the world, O God. Endow them with humble courage to defend the cause of the poor and give deliverance to those in need, so that peace abounds in all countries. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
By the guidance of the star, you led the Magi to pay homage to the Christ child. Protect their families, those who live alone, travelers, those who suffer loss, and all others in need, especially Herb Schaefering, Mary Kramer, Peter Bryan, Marcy Moore, Carl and Linda Johnson, Emmy and Mike Wallenberg, Dennis Kelly, Susan Quadman, those on our prayer list, and those who often help either silently or aloud.
Sharon Matusha.
Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We pray your protection and comfort, O God, for our brothers and sisters in Australia. We pray continuing comfort and guidance for those whose houses of worship require security guards. We pray your continued protection for our children who must learn how to do active shooter drills.
Thank you. Thank you.